Right from the 19th of November 2010, when the Airtel brand was launched in Nigeria, the leading communication services provider has been touching the lives of Nigerians. Consistent in its quest to revolutionize the country's mobile telecommunications landscape. Today, it is regarded as a pioneer of innovation and affordability in the country. And yes, Airtel is also popular for its large kind heart and people-centric approach to the business of mobile telephony. Over the last 4 years, Airtel has been enriching the lives of Nigerians through a variety of well-articulated CSR programs designed to uplift the less privileged, offer succor, and real hope to the disadvantaged. Indeed, Airtel has connected emotionally with millions of Nigerians just as it has won the love of several consumers. From the north to the east, south to the west, Airtel has earned its social license to operate, to serve Nigerians, and also touch the lives of the less privileged. Even Airtel's approach to giving CSR is revolutionary. It broke records and changed the game of corporate social investments when it announced in 2011 its Adopt a School program. With this initiative, Airtel pledged to literally adopt less privileged kids, offer them a world-class primary education, and ensure they got all the supplies, from books, school bags, to uniforms, writing materials, all covered for. In essence, Airtel said it will identify, nurture, and develop underprivileged children in different parts of the country. True to its words, the company completed the pilot in record time, 90 days, when it transformed Oremeji Primary School to Ajegunle, Lagos, offering the kids real hope. It quickly moved to other parts of the country, transforming schools and empowering underprivileged children in Presbyterian Primary School, Ediba, Cross River, St. John's Primary School, Okabo, Ijebuibo, Ogun State, and Community Primary School, Amumara, Imo State. In Oremeji Primary School, for example, the structure was in abysmal condition, not suitable for learning. Airtel, upon signing a memorandum of understanding with the state government through the State Universal Basic Education Board, SUBEB, demolished the old structure and built a block of 6 classrooms, teachers' offices, world-standard toilet facilities with furniture. Airtel provided a borehole with water treatment plants, music band set, and in partnership with Meccano, donated a 10 kVA generator to Oremeji Primary School. In addition, every year the pupils receive educational materials in form of exercise books, pen, school bags, and uniforms, courtesy of Airtel. With this intervention, the population of pupils in the school has grown from 215 to 308 in the last few years, excluding the 3 sets of primary 6 pupils that have passed out since the adoption by the telco. In 2012, Airtel collaborated with GlaxoSmithKline, GSK, to organize a deworming and health check program at Oremeji Primary School, where many pupils from the school and the neighboring areas benefited from this exercise. In 2013, football legend from the Arsenal Football Club, Robert Pires, paid a visit to the school. He spent some time playing football with the kids and talked to them about the value of education. Under the Adopt a School project, Airtel in 2013 commissioned a block of 4 classrooms for pupils of St. John Primary School in Ogun State, and renovated teachers' offices as well. The ceremony was attended by the First Lady of Ogun State, Mrs. Olufunso Amosun. In the same year, pupils were provided educational materials such as exercise books, pens, bags, and school uniforms. A borehole was also provided for the pupils and teachers in order to provide them with potable water and prevent waterborne diseases. As a result of the infrastructural development, the school population has grown from 774 to 1,000 pupils. In the same year, the Presbyterian Primary School Ediba, Cross River, was provided with a well-furnished block of 8 classrooms, while a block of 10 classrooms was renovated in Community Primary School Amumara, Imo State. The commissioning of the projects were graced by the state's commissioners of education. Boreholes were handed over to the schools for potable water, and on a yearly basis, all the adopted schools are provided with educational materials such as exercise books, bags, and uniforms. Also, Airtel in 2014 organized a free eye screening exercise in its adopted schools in Ogun, Cross River, and Imo States, where corrective glasses were given free. Over 2,000 pupils, teachers, and community members benefited from this exercise. Another major vehicle through which the telco has demonstrated its large heart is by the means of its employee volunteer scheme, a platform that offers staff of the company opportunities to directly participate in CSR programs, either through monthly financial contributions or volunteering their time to help the less privileged. Through the scheme, the lives of young children have been saved. Examples abound. Through the program, staff of Airtel came to the aid of a boy who was born with a condition that prevented him from passing feces through his rectum. At age 5, the boy had undergone several surgeries to rectify the predicament. His condition, however, required a final surgery estimated at 5.6 million, which would enable him to live a normal life. From the resources pulled together by the staff under the employee volunteer scheme, the surgery was done, also covering other expenses of up to 1.5 million for the medical bills, medication, and transportation. Another beneficiary of the employee volunteer scheme was a girl born with a hole in the heart. The scheme proved vital to the life of the young girl, who was successfully operated in India, with Airtel providing half of the medical expenses. Recently, the Airtel employee volunteer scheme came to the aid of a young boy who was diagnosed with a medical condition known as hydrocephalus. Through the help of Airtel staff, the condition was corrected at the University Teaching Hospital, Ibadan. Airtel has further revolutionized the CSR landscape in Nigeria with an initiative tagged Airtel Touching Lives, launched recently with the aim of identifying and providing help for needy people in our society. The launch marked a turning point in the company's effort to earn the social license to operate as a corporate responsible risk citizen, and also brought it closer to its avowed vision. Airtel Touching Lives was premiered on December 18, 2014. At a colorful event at the Oriental Hotel Victoria Island, Lagos. The guests could not hold back their tears as they watched the 30-minute episode. The emotion-evoking event brought to limelight the commitment and kind-heartedness of Airtel in uplifting the conditions of the underprivileged people through its CSR interventions. Undoubtedly, the driving force and passion behind the company's CSR activities is more than a mere goal of exhibiting philanthropic gestures. It is one born out of genuine love for humanity and deep conviction to contribute positively to improving the quality of lives and bring smiles to the faces of people who yearn for a helping hand. Airtel CEO Segun Ogunsoya puts it thus: Airtel Touching Lives is our major pillar for giving. It is not for exposure. It is not a publicity drive. It is born out of our genuine desire to build an equitable society, a society where the strong supports the weak. If you are big, the society places some obligations on you. It is an obligation we accept willingly. We are passionate about the people we serve and the Nigerian society. Airtel Touching Lives provides a platform for the underprivileged in society to be identified, heard, and also cared for. For Mr. Emeka Opara, Director of Corporate Communications and CSR, Airtel Touching Lives is a journey from hardship to the getaway of a better life. With this deliberate intervention, Airtel is not only complementing government efforts, non-governmental organizations, and highly spirited Nigerians who share the Airtel humanitarian spirit, but also giving back to the society. We are targeting those who are already doing something to help the less privileged in the society, like NGOs and humanitarians. This emotional connection becomes the universal story of triumph. Yes, Airtel is committed to its vision of enriching the lives of all its stakeholders. At Airtel, we sell, we care, we give. Was provided with a well-furnished block of 8 classrooms, while a block of 10 classrooms was renovated in Community Primary School Amumara, Imo State. The commissioning of the projects were graced by the state's commissioners of education. Boreholes were handed over to the schools for potable water, and on a yearly basis, all the adopted schools are provided with educational materials such as exercise books, bags, and uniforms. Also, Airtel in 2014 organized a free eye screening exercise in its adopted schools in Ogun, Cross River, and Imo States, where corrective glasses were given free. Over 2,000 pupils, teachers, and community members benefited from this exercise. Another major vehicle through which the telco has demonstrated its large heart is by the means of its employee volunteer scheme, a platform that offers staff of the company opportunities to directly participate in CSR programs, either through monthly financial contributions or volunteering their time to help the less privileged. Through the scheme, the lives of young children have been saved. Examples abound. Through the program, staff of Airtel came to the aid of a boy who was born with a condition that prevented him from passing phases through his rectum. At age 5, the boy had undergone several surgeries to rectify the predicament. His condition, however, required a final surgery estimated at 5.6 million, which would enable him to live a normal life to 308 in the last few years. Excluding the 3 sets of primary 6 pupils that have passed out since the adoption by the telco. In 2012, Airtel collaborated with GlaxoSmithKline, GSK, to organize a deworming and health check program at Oremeji Primary School, where many pupils from the school and the neighboring areas benefited from this exercise. In 2013, football legend from the Arsenal Football Club, Robert Pires, paid a visit to the school. He spent some time playing football with the kids and talked to them about the value of education. Under the Adopt a School project, Airtel in 2013 commissioned a block of 4 classrooms for pupils of St. John Primary School in Ogun State and renovated teachers' offices as well. The ceremony was attended by the First Lady of Ogun State, Mrs. Olufunso Amosun. In the same year, pupils were provided educational materials such as exercise books, pens, bags, and school uniforms. A borehole was also provided for the pupils and teachers in order to provide them with potable water and prevent waterborne diseases. As a result of the infrastructural development, the school population has grown from 774 to 1,000 pupils. In the same year, the Presbyterian Primary School Ediba, Crossview. Right from the 19th of November 2010, when the Airtel brand was launched in Nigeria, the leading communication services provider has been touching the lives of Nigerians, consistent in its quest to revolutionize the country's mobile telecommunications landscape. Today, it is regarded as a pioneer of innovation and affordability in the country. And yes, Airtel is also popular for its large kind heart and people-centric approach to the business of mobile telephony. Over the last 4 years, Airtel has been enriching the lives of Nigerians through a variety of well-articulated CSR programs designed to uplift the less privileged, offer succor, and real hope to the disadvantaged. Indeed, Airtel has connected emotionally with millions of Nigerians just as it has won the love of several consumers. From the north to the east, south to the west, Airtel has earned its social license to operate, to serve Nigerians, and also touch the lives of the less privileged. Even Airtel's approach to giving CSR is revolutionary. It broke records and changed the game of corporate social investments when it announced in 2011 its Adopt a School program. With this initiative, Airtel pledged to literally adopt less privileged kids, offer them a world-class primary education, and ensure they got all the supplies, from books, school bags, to uniforms, writing materials, all covered for. In essence, Airtel said it will identify, nurture, and develop underprivileged children in different parts of the country. True to its words, the company completed the pilot in record time, 90 days, when it transformed Oremeji Primary School 2, Ajegunle, Lagos, offering the kids real hope. It quickly moved to other parts of the country, transforming schools and empowering underprivileged children in Presbyterian Primary School, Ediba, Cross River, St. John's Primary School, Okabo, Ijebuibo, Ogun State, and Community Primary School, Amumara, Imo State. In Oremeji Primary School, for example, the structure was in abysmal condition, not suitable for learning. Airtel, upon signing a memorandum of understanding with the state government through the State Universal Basic Education Board, SUBEB, demolished the old structure and built a block of 6 classrooms, teachers' offices, world-standard toilet facilities with furniture. Airtel provided a borehole with water treatment plants, music band set, and in partnership with Mikano, donated a 10 kVA generator to Oremeji Primary School. In addition, every year the pupils receive educational materials in form of exercise books, pen, school bags, and uniforms, courtesy of Airtel. With this intervention, the population of pupils in the school has grown from 215. From the resources pulled together by the staff under the employee volunteer scheme, the surgery was done, also covering other expenses of up to 1.5 million for the medical bills, medication, and transportation. Another beneficiary of the employee volunteer scheme was a girl born with a hole in the heart. The scheme proved vital to the life of the young girl, who was successfully operated in India, with Airtel providing half of the medical expenses. Recently, the Airtel Employee Volunteer Scheme came to the aid of a young boy who was diagnosed with a medical condition known as hydrocephalus. Through the help of Airtel staff, the condition was corrected at the University Teaching Hospital, Ibadan. Airtel has further revolutionized the CSR landscape in Nigeria with an initiative tagged Airtel Touching Lives, launched recently with the aim of identifying and providing help for needy people in our society. The launch marked a turning point in the company's effort to earn the social license to operate as a corporate responsible risk citizen and also brought it closer to its avowed vision. Airtel Touching Lives was premiered on December 18, 2014, at a colorful event at the Oriental Hotel Victoria Island, Lagos. The guests could not hold back their tears as they watched the 30-minute episode. The emotion-evoking event brought to limelight the commitment and kind-heartedness of Airtel in uplifting the conditions of the underprivileged people through its CSR intervention.